chapter 1.
All right, good. Mark up my face, bro.
This has been an awesome service thus far. It is great to be out here. And I'm looking forward to seeing Desiree get baptized at the
Let's go!
I do want to welcome as well somebody that is visiting with us as well. Our dear brother Earl's right there.
Earl! I love you, Earl!
Been more of a time than right now for people to answer this call, to be fishers of men. Are you with me?
Come on, bro.
I think we can all agree here this morning that this world is not getting any better.
Nope.
But there are so many people drowning.
Yeah.
Spiritually, are you with me?
Talk about it, bro.
Thank God. I read the news every day, but man, it just seems like it's just getting worse and worse. Are you with me?
Yeah.
I mean, so much darkness, so much famine, so much greed, so many selfish people. Are you with me?
Yeah.
People sinking more and more into debt. So much more religiosity. I mean, I was talking with somebody yesterday, just thinking pray political here, amen.
Yeah,
amen.
We believe that we should have guns and all that stuff. Like, I mean, just thinking like that. That's the problem is the soul, it's the heart.
Right.
I mean, man, the kids in these days, God is just being pushed out of the schools, pushed out of the hearts and minds of people. Are you with me?
Right. Yeah.
That's why we got to answer the call to seek and to save what was lost.
Yeah.
Right. And today's lesson title is just simply just that. Seek and save what was lost. We're going to study out a passage here in Luke 19. It's Jesus' interaction with a man by the name of Zacchaeus. And I think it's important for us to see this and to see this is what Jesus' life was all about.
Yeah.
Was touching people. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And here in this interaction, it's only just 10 verses. There's so much packed into this. In Luke 19 and verse 1, Jesus is on his way to Jerusalem. And he's making his way there because that's where he's going. That's his final stop because he knows that that's where he's going to get arrested and all this thing. He's going to die on a cross.
Yeah.
And he's passing through Jericho. We find this right here in verse 1. It says, Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. A man was there by the name of Zacchaeus, and he was a chief tax collector and was wealthy. He wanted to see who Jesus was, but being a short man, he could not because of the crowd. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore fig tree to see him. Since Jesus was coming that way, when Jesus reached the spot, he looked up and said to him, Zacchaeus, come down immediately. I must stay at your house today. And so he came down at once and welcomed him gladly. All the people saw this and began to mutter, he's gone to be the guest of a sinner. But Zacchaeus stood up and said to him, Lord, here now I give half of my possessions to the poor. And if I have cheated anybody out of anything, I'll pay back four times the amount. And Jesus said to him, today salvation has come to this house because this man too is the son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save what was lost. My first point is get down from the tree.
Dang.
Get down from the tree. Jesus, making his way to Jerusalem, rolling through Jericho. Word goes out that he's going through Jericho, and a commotion starts, and you gotta imagine there's a parade of people just coming and flocking to the street that he's walking by. And we find here in this moment, Zacchaeus. Well, what do we know about Zacchaeus? Zacchaeus, the Bible describes him, and Zacchaeus hears this, right? Zacchaeus happens to be a chief tax collector, as the Bible says. That's who he is. We know he's a short dude, right? Probably less than 5 feet tall.
Oh,
right?
Whoa.
Short guy. And remember the movies of the 80s and the 90s, when I think of Zacchaeus, I think of Danny DeVito.
Yeah,
sure guy, I could have balled in right there. If I were to make a movie, I'd put Danny DeVito as Zacchaeus.
Yeah.
Right?
Danny DeVito.
And we find Zacchaeus, and he's a chief tax collector. If you know anything about tax collectors in this time, the Romans who were occupying Jerusalem at the time would hire Jews, right, as their tax collectors to go tax their people and then go collect the money. So the Jewish people didn't really like Zacchaeus so much because he'd be the one extorting money and taking money from them.
Yeah.
And if you're a tax collector, what you would do is you would go take the tax, but you would actually get a little bit more because that extra stuff would go into your pocket and then you give Rome what theirs was, right?
Yeah.
And this guy was a chief tax collector. So that meant that he had a crew that he was overseeing to go take the taxes from the people. So not a lot of people probably liked Zacchaeus. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Another thing that I didn't know before is Zacchaeus' name actually means pure, innocent. Well, I don't think that he's living a pure and innocent life at this moment. But we see that God's got a plan for everybody. We might not be living up to our name, but Jesus is like, no, you're going to live up to my name, and I'm going to reach out to you and call you to the destiny that you were born for.
Come on.
And that's what we see happening right here with Zacchaeus.
Let's go, bro.
At the time, we see that he exemplified everything wrong with what we think is wrong with the world today. Right? Greed, corruption, and self-indulgence. Right before this, in Luke 18, it's very interesting, we see Jesus' interaction with the rich young ruler.
Yeah.
Right? And Jesus challenged the rich young ruler to give up everything. And he does it. And Jesus says, well, with man, this is impossible. But not with God. All things are possible with God. But it is hard for a rich man to get to the kingdom of heaven. And then we get right here in Zacchaeus, and we're going to see this miracle right here, where he actually does give up everything. Because we know this guy was wealthy. This is what the Bible says. Are you with me?
Right.
Zacchaeus hears about the commotion. Hears about Jesus rolling through. It's like, whoa, hey, this guy known as the Messiah is rolling through? Oh, I gotta go check this out. Who is this guy? This guy from Nazareth. I gotta go check this guy out. So he wants to go check it out. It's like if you were here and like, you know, if you found out there's gonna be a parade for like, I don't know who, what, Taylor Swift maybe?
Oh gosh, no.
Justin Bieber, I don't know.
No.
Dylan would probably be fired up if you guys know who Zante is. I gotta go check this out!
Still missing.
I gotta go check this out! If some of you had free tickets to go see the wedding, the royal wedding, you'd probably be there like, I gotta go check this out, right? Who's this celebrity rolling through? I gotta go find out who this is.
You gotta keep going.
You got like a crowd of people right there.
Beaches,
bro. He wants to go see this. But there was a problem. He was short.
What's wrong with you? Come on, Vito.
You gotta imagine the crowd of people that's back there, he couldn't see. You know, you ever been like, you got like the best spot. You ain't let nobody in, right?
Damn.
Oh my God. Screw the title.
Oh, dang.
Right? You know, nobody get in there, right? And so what does he do? He's like, climb that tree right there.
Yes.
This wealthy guy, this professional, decides like, I'm gonna climb a tree.
Yeah. Come on, Peter.
Right, and then it reminds me, like, also in Luke 18, verses 15 and 17, it talks about in order to get into heaven, you gotta have faith like a child. So we see this illustration being lived out right here with Zacchaeus. What do kids love to do? They like to climb trees.
Yes.
Let's go.
So you see this childlike car, like, he's curious to see Jesus, like, I'm gonna climb a tree.
Yay.
You gotta picture this guy in his robe and all this stuff trying to like climb a tree and Santa Claus. But he gets up there!
Chancletas.
And he's perched up there, taking a look at Jesus walking by. And what does he see? Probably just some ordinary dude. No pomp, no circumstance, no real celebration. It wasn't like a band was rolling, it was just Jesus rolling through. It's like, whoa. Looking like a king, but actually really being a king. Right?
Yeah.
He wanted to see Jesus. That's what the Bible says. And this is what we have today. A lot of people want to see Jesus. They're curious.
True.
I want to check out Christianity. At least some of you this morning came here like, just check out church. We're curious. I don't really want to dive all in, but just check out Jesus. Right? You can be that way with the Bible. Like, oh, I've heard about the Bible. I've heard about the good book. And
let's go.
Let's just really see if it actually is good. Yeah. You want to try it out. You just want it. You want to see.
Dang.
You're not really ready to commit, but you just want to see. And that's where Zacchaeus was at. And he's thinking, if I just perch myself up in that branch and just hide out, then I can see Jesus. Right, we can think like, we don't think that Jesus sees us. Right, we want to see him. The reality is we are actually hiding and thinking, but what does we roll up? Jesus rolls up to that spot.
Yep.
He looks up. And you know that the whole time, because he's Lord, he knew Zacchaeus is up there. You got to imagine a sea of people just boxed in right there and everything like that, and Jesus stops. And then he looks up. He addresses Zacchaeus. I like to imagine everything stops and the crowd just parts away and all eyes are on Zacchaeus. He's like, uh-oh. And Jesus says, Zacchaeus. Yeah, you know I'm up in the tree, dude. I must stay at your house.
Wow.
Stay. And Jesus calls him by name. That probably blew him away. Like, whoa,
I didn't know my name.
Lord. And he knew him, and he called him by name, and he says, hey, Zacchaeus, come down. I must stay at your house. And I love it because you see Jesus approaching like a friend. He called him by name. And don't we love being called by our name, right? When somebody knows your name.
Don't call me on my name.
You remember my name.
Yeah.
It means a lot to us, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then you see also being a friend, but also being a king and commanding like, hey, dude, come down.
Yeah.
I got to stay at your house, man.
Amen.
Instead of maybe, like, we gotta hang. We got to spend some time.
Yeah.
And Zacchaeus was only trying to get a glance of Jesus, right?
Yeah.
Only come to find out that Jesus the whole time was seeking after him.
Wow.
What is the very first question of the Bible? Genesis 3 verse 9, God says, Adam, where are you? God has always been asking, where are you at? Why are you running from me?
Come on, bro.
Because he wants to marry us. He wants a bride. And Zacchaeus was hiding, thinking, I'm like, no, Jesus, like, no, no, it's time to stop hiding.
Yeah.
Where are you at? God has always been seeking after us to bring his kids back home with him.
Yeah.
And this morning, he's calling us to get out of the tree.
Dang.
And to come down.
Yeah, bro.
And to stop hiding. I'll never forget, for me, where I was hiding my branch the other day was just my life. Calling myself a Christian, but knowing the whole time I'm not really living like a Christian. I couldn't even tell you what a Christian was.
Come on, bro.
Just like, I just go to church. And I was hiding out in my own life. Didn't want anybody to really know what was going on.
Yeah.
Kind of put on a facade. When I had hair, it was slicked back and all that stuff. I tried to live.
Rico fly.
So am I.
It was home.
I was.
You
think everybody else knew what was going on? Like, no, you ain't Rico. He's trying to have the car, having fancy clothes, trying to go to the restaurants, trying to live the life, right? Went to my royal wedding one day, but I think if I would have had that, I probably would have divorced like 2 years later. Who knows if I would have made it that long?
Yeah.
Currently keep a relationship for about 6 months, and finally she caught on like, you ain't ever changing. You always like this?
Come on, Barney.
Bye, Felicia.
Right? The honeymoon phase gets out like, oh, this is how you are all the time. I don't think I want to sign up for that. Every now and then I'd check in, going to church, trying to feel good, want to hear a feel-good message and have some emotional experience, and it wouldn't last long because I hadn't had nobody in my life calling me back to the Bible.
Yeah.
So it's no different from you sitting on the seat to the person out there on the street.
Yeah.
Until finally I was like, you know what, I got to stop hiding. Let me see Jesus, let me see God's Word. And I was like, oh snap. So I really can't hide that. I really got to get down from the tree. And I'm grateful. I mean, 16 years ago, I answered the call after wrestling with the scriptures, after called to give up everything and really make Jesus Lord. I was baptized on July 28, 2002 for the forgiveness of my
sins. Let's go, bro.
I became a disciple.
Woo!
And I heard God through his word, asking where I was at. And I'm so fired up to come in that relationship with my father.
Yes, sir.
And that is the same call for every single one of us. And you got to think this morning, I challenge this morning, Acts 17, 26, 27 says, God chooses the times and places where people live.
Yeah.
So perhaps you'd seek after him and find him. So there are no coincidences with God.
Right.
And you got to think through your life this morning. The church services you've been through, the conversations you've had, the people you're friends with, the times and the opportunities, many times where God has sought after you. Put this person in your life. You being here at service this morning, it's not coincidence. God is calling you to come down from the tree. To stop hiding. Whatever branch it might be. To get off the tree. To see him. For him to come and teach you through his word what it really means to follow him. What it really means to give up everything. What it really means to have a relationship. That you would sit down and study his word.
Yeah.
And come into a true relationship with him.
Yeah.
Because he came to seek and to save what was lost.
Yeah.
And that is you. If you don't have a true relationship with God.
Yeah.
And I challenge you this morning to answer that call. You will not be disappointed. It is good news. Are you with me?
It's true.
You come down from that tree.
Yes, it is.
You can also do my second point. Grab up the fruit from the tree and seek and save the lost world. Let's continue on. My second point, grab the fruits on the tree. In verse 5, Jesus gets to that spot and tells Zacchaeus to come down immediately. He says, I got to stay at your house. Zacchaeus welcomes him gladly and has him over, right? All the people begin to mutter like, Jesus is going hanging out with a sinner. Like, what the heck is going on right now? And then all this talking going on. Something happens at the house. You know, Jesus is preaching to him and like sharing the gospel and all that stuff. Zacchaeus' response in verse 8, he stands up and he's like, hey, Lord. And he makes this decision. I tell you what, Lord, hey, here's what I'm going to do. I'm giving half my possessions to the poor. And if I cheated at anybody out of anything, Jesus, I'm going to pay them back four times the amount. And he says, Zacchaeus, verse 9, today, salvation has come to this house.
Yeah.
Because this man, too, is the son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save what was lost.
Amen.
Such a powerful interaction, right?
Yeah.
Grab the fruit from the tree.
Amen.
This is what we do as disciples. Are you with me?
Yes,
amen,
sir.
Brother.
We grab the fruit from the tree. Usually where fruit grows from, right? I mean, that's where apples grow from, right?
I hope.
Apples produce apples. Oranges produce
oranges.
Cherries produce
cherries.
All right, so you're with me, right? So disciples produce
disciples.
Hey, man, you're with me.
Yeah.
So we grab the fruit from the tree. The souls of men and women.
Amen.
Jesus comes to Zacchaeus. And we see the urgency. He says, Zacchaeus. Hey, come down immediately. I gotta stay at your house. So I can totally use this and like, hey, this is good. Like, hey man, Claudia, I gotta come over to you guys' house. I must stay. It's a great invitation to have a meal over at somebody else's house. Amen?
True.
Right? No problem.
Prophecy, Claudia.
I feel good about it.
Amen.
Are you all right?
He says, I gotta stay at your home. Like, I don't know if like Zacchaeus had like a bed and breakfast going on right there, but Jesus says, hey, I gotta stay at your house, dude.
Well, yeah.
I don't know how long I'm gonna be there, but I gotta stay open. He literally inserts himself into Zacchaeus' life, right?
Yeah.
Now,
let's go, Toya.
A lot of us,
hey,
are extroverted.
Go,
you know, extroverted, this challenged you.
Yes, sir.
Actually, I don't know how many people actually like people.
Oh.
I mean, that must actually really like people. You know? I mean, the extroverts are like, yeah, I love people.
Yes.
I do so much fun just hanging around people. So much like people. Oh, hey.
I love you guys.
I love you, but I love you this much. I got to take you in doses.
Oh, hey, preach that word, Jacob.
I'm sorry, Aaron. I was like, I'm hanging out with you for like an hour and a half. Like, all right, cool. I'll see you later. I may or may not be at the barbecue. I don't know.
I already had enough
of you that I could handle today. Good.
I got my fill. know what I'm talking about?
Dang.
I'm talking about, man, that's the way I can be sometimes. Like, it's just like, it's funny that God called me to be a preacher.
Oh, dang.
But naturally, like, I'm an emotional introvert.
Oh, sure.
It's easy for me to go by my feelings, but I just, like, I like my bubble and my space. I'm good right here.
Preach, bro.
I'm good right here. Don't burst it. I want to be friends with you, but you burst this bubble, I don't know.
I preach that word, baby.
I got to remind that, like, all right, I got to be like Jesus. Amen.
Don't fuck with me.
Jose's love language is like physical touch, and I think if he notices a lot more lately, that I've been touching him a lot more, but more like, dude, no. He shaved his head, so I've been like rubbing the back of his head lately.
Let's go!
My last like,
big old nugget.
Close the bar.
Look at that smile. He can't grab the fruit if we don't insert ourselves into people's lives.
Yeah.
This is the call for the extroverted and the introverted. Are you with me?
Come on, introverts.
It doesn't matter what you are a disciple of Christ.
Amen.
And we've got to reach people. Are you with me?
Right.
And Jesus says, hey, I've got to stay at your place. Why? Today, immediately. Because Jesus understood that today is the day of salvation. Are you with me?
Right.
Right. 2 Corinthians 6, verse 1 says, as God's co-worker, we urge you not to receive God's grace in vain. For he says, in the time of my favor, I heard you. In the day of salvation, I helped you. This is, hey, as God's co-worker. So we understand a disciple is a Christian, is a worker. You remember when we did that right there, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
And so what helps us work, what fuels it? It's God's grace, amen?
Amen, brother.
It's you being fired up that you're saved.
Yeah.
And you're so grateful for your salvation that you want to share that with the entire nation.
Amen.
Are you with me?
Yeah.
Everybody. You just been like, man, I got to invite you out to church. Why? Because it's awesome.
Yeah. Right.
You got to come to my Bible. You got to come to my family.
Thank you.
Can we sit down and study the Bible?
Right.
Can I just share how awesome God is with you?
Right.
Right. What's helping you do that? It's the grace of God.
Yeah.
Outside of that, if we're not working, if we're not fighting to win souls, then how much is the grace of God really with us? Are you with me?
That's true.
Yeah.
Then it really is just pointless. Right? Are you with me?
Yeah.
And Jesus right here is sharing, doing an example for us, like, whoa, dude, hey, I gotta stay at your house, man. Alright? I'm passing through. I don't know if I'm gonna get another opportunity to see you, so I gotta talk to you right now. And he initiates with them. And Zacchaeus' life is forever changed. And I love it because Zacchaeus was so grateful that Jesus initiated with him. Picture him jumping down from the tree. He's like, yeah, absolutely. Come on over. And invites him over. I'm not sure he had a nice little spread for him and everything like that. They just had a good time. Talking over the scriptures, talking over life. I mean, man, to have the Messiah in your home. Man, the questions you could just ask him. And just, gee, the knowledge that you were just dropping just blew Zacchaeus away. Like, I'm ready to repent. Let's go. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
And he decides. The verse 8, he says, hey, I'm going to give half of what I own to the poor.
Yeah.
50%. Half, like, boom, I get to the pool right now. Half my stuff. Imagine you doing it. And then he says, hey, I'm actually even willing to pay back 400 times if I cheated anybody. You know that's probably true. He probably did cheat people, you think? And so we see this guy fully repent and change. It was obvious, right? Completely different heart than the rich young ruler.
Yeah.
Who didn't want to give up everything in Luke 18, are you with me? And most likely this guy cheated people at hundreds, maybe thousands of people. And to think that he was willing to give half his stuff to the poor, then pay back 400%, truly we don't know if this guy was going to have anything left. Showing the heart of somebody completely sold out. Isn't that awesome?
Let's go, bro.
The Old Testament, I know you're wondering this, like, well, what's the big point? Well, the Old Testament says that if you steal something from somebody, you got to pay them back what you stole plus 20%.
Wow.
Right?
Man.
So, if Zacchaeus was like, all right, I'll get back what I stole, and then here's 20%. God would have been fine with it. He'd be like, all right, cool. All right, that's cool. But this guy goes the extra mile. He goes 50%. And he says, well, now if you rob somebody, you had to pay them back double or 200%. That's what it says in Exodus 22, verse 1 to 7. So what has he decided to do? Pay back 400%.
Wow.
Woo!
He goes the extra mile.
Let's go.
Really showing the heart of somebody that's really in touch with God's grace, and a disciple that's grateful to be saved. Like, man, I'm willing to give up everything.
Let's go.
And this guy being wealthy, showing his true heart.
Fired up, bro.
Let me show us being fired up about our salvation or grateful by two commodities that are close to our hearts.
Mm-hmm.
Our time and our money.
Yes, bro.
Preach! Are you with me? Preach! He's like, man, I'm going to sacrifice everything.
Yeah.
And I believe with all my heart that the Sacramento Church is a very sacrificial church.
Amen.
So I am absolutely confident we're going to blow out our special mission.
Let's go.
The thing that's fueling you and what's helping you blow it out to see more souls saved, just like your soul was saved, is the grace of God.
Yeah.
I want to challenge right here, not to just hit your goal, but to blow it out.
Come on.
If you haven't turned anything in yet, I challenge you to turn in what you can.
Yeah.
Amen.
Are you with me?
Yeah.
We're all fighting for this.
Yeah.
But it takes a family to blow this out.
Right.
We're going to lift up just the people that have come out and labored and tagged. We've tagged like 12 times since, like, I think we started in March, right? We took March off.
Amen.
Took March off. Man, we've been killing it in April, right?
That's right.
And I'm so proud of everybody coming out and just pouring out their hearts.
Yeah.
You know, and I texted like 7 or 8 people on Saturday.
Amen.
Or on Friday night. I was like, let me just see. I'll put the ball in their court. And the majority of them were like, dude, let's go.
Yes.
Nice.
I'm like, hey, we only have a few people that are going to go out and tag and ask for donations. Right? That's what tagging is, right?
Fired up.
And like, the majority of them are like, hey, dude, I'm with you heart and soul. Let's go.
Yeah.
You know, one for one after the other, like, hey, let's go. Let's do it.
Yeah.
I'm like, dang. And Lord bless it. I mean, in just a few hours, you guys raised over like $400.
Let's go, Jose.
Yeah. And it's been the grace of God that's helped, that's fueling you to work. That's it. Which is awesome. Totally like Christ. Are you with me?
Yeah.
That's being sold out. Amen.
Amen.
And
on, Jacob.
What are we fighting for? The hope for Columbus, Ohio.
Yeah.
For the state of Ohio.
Let's go.
The state of Wisconsin. I'm fired up. Next year, we're planning a church in Salt Lake City, Utah.
Let's go. Let's go.
Let's go, Utah.
Let's go.
Sacramento playing a huge role in that. Are you with me?
Wow. Yeah, this is true.
Right between us, San Francisco, our sister church in Eugene and Portland, and I think Denver as well, right, are getting the people and most likely the funds as well to go plant that church. Are you with me?
Sure.
Which is
Let's
awesome.
Go, bro.
Right? But also as well, another church in the south is going to be planted, Atlanta, Georgia.
Let's go, Atlanta. Come on. Yeah. Let's go, Atlanta. Yeah. Hey,
reach out to us.
Hey, town.
The gospel is being preached everywhere. Isn't that exciting?
Yeah. Fired up, bro.
You know, Jesus responds, we're going to finish up with this, in verses 9 to 10, with a declaration and a proclamation and a purpose statement. He says, salvation has come to this house. And he says, for he too is a son of Abraham. Remember, Zacchaeus was a Jew.
That's right.
Right? Zacchaeus, right, is not very liked by his people, the Jewish people. He says, hey, salvation has come to this house. And Zacchaeus, too, is a son of Abraham.
Mm-hmm.
And I love it, though. And this is a great message for us, though. And I appreciate Daisha sharing her heart for community. And just, you know, I mean, many of us come from a lot of just tough situations.
Oh, yeah.
Appreciate it, bro.
Some of us experience being casting out from our own families, friends, and not really loving. Why we don't trust so much and why the walls are up. And, why it is weird if you say you love you. Like, whoa. I just met you yesterday.
Yeah. I still love you.
Tell me you love me. Sometimes when you come visit, you're like, why do you want to hug me? I don't really understand. Right? You're not really used to that love.
Yeah.
But that is the kingdom of God. And I love right here that Jesus said, hey, you might not be accepted in your own community, but let me tell you about the true community, the kingdom of God. The salvation has come to you, and now you really are, Zacchaeus, part of the family. Welcome home.
Come on, Jacob.
Come on, bro.
Jesus says why he came to this earth was to seek and to save what was lost. Exhibit A, Zacchaeus. And as the spring comes to a close, and we're getting ready for the summer to begin, this does not mean that we take a break from our purpose.
Yeah.
Although we'll be going on trips and all these things.
Right.
There are still people that Jesus wants us to meet. Are you with me?
Yeah.
There are people that Jesus wants us to share the scriptures with. Are you with me?
Yeah.
And this means that we have a summer search.
Yes.
That we maintain the forceful advancement. Are you with me?
Yeah.
That we are fueled by that gratitude of our salvation.
Mm-hmm.
And that we're going to grab the fruit that's on the tree.
Let's go.
I want to challenge the church right now. I want to challenge us today. To make those follow-up calls to people that we reached out to, that maybe we haven't talked to in a while. But reach out and touch them like Jesus did.
Yeah.
I challenge us to go after those that have fallen away, that we're still talking to. And ask them to come back. Ask them to sit down, talk, touch, reach out and touch them. Are you with me?
Mm-hmm.
And I challenge us, as we get ready for the summer to begin, I don't want every member to go after asking somebody to study the Bible. This is our purpose.
Yeah.
And we're called to be workers. And why is this so important? Because if we're not about our purpose, if we're not consumed with trying to help somebody else be a Christian, what are we going to be consumed with? Ourselves.
Yep.
And let me tell you what, that is a recipe for disaster.
Yeah.
Right? Every single issue becomes a big mountain.
Yeah.
No problems, are you with me?
Yeah.
You start focusing on your own problems, how much money you don't have, you know, the girlfriend or boyfriend that you don't have, right? The car's not working, all this, what you don't have, right? And then, but when you preach, like, find out, and somebody sees their loss, I go, hey, I gotta help you on out. Right? When you sit in a cross study and preach the gospel to somebody, how about how Jesus died for your sins? Your problems don't seem that big anymore, are you with me? That's why Jesus gave us a purpose. He wasn't stupid. So I challenge you to go at this with all of our hearts. Are you with me? And if you're here visiting with us this morning, I challenge you as well to study the Bible. I challenge you to get in the scriptures and answer the call to get down from the tree so you could be with Jesus for eternity. Are you with me? He's calling you to a life that's incredible, filled with so many promises, so that you too can become just like the first disciples in Mark chapter 1, a fisher of men. So you can be filled with that incredible purpose, and you too, with the rest of us, can seek and save this lost world. I love you very much.
Amen.
Come on, Jacob.